I like the Slark pick, though. It's to tip the balance in their favor, I would say, but at least you have a win condition now. Slark is one of the hard counters to bat and jug.
Very, very deep. The smoke hasn't broken until now on Jirax. He's looking for a target. S4 is going to be it. He knows it too. The rest of EG is still there. The first wave of poison comes out. Sockshka looking to wrap around the back as... Oh, this is a very dead Jirax. He does not escape from this. The rest of OG is already backed off, and EG will spill first blood.
Nice. And they give it to Arteezy as well.
Where he's able to harass out of lane, but how do you harass the entire lane? Yeah. There's three heroes looking for you. Cogburn, Snowball forward. The level two has arrived just in time for Crit to close the distance over on Seb. No TP away attempted. He's just going to accept his own fate.
Nobody can show up to Slark's lane and say, oh, you've got to leave now. And it's very easy for them to play around him because of the global mobility of Clock and Prophet.
Going for the 5-minute rune. Sockshka just going to put the cogs in. They want to try and keep flying up on the high ground. There's already three Shadow Poison stacks. A fourth will ensure the kill. In fact, Jurek just pops him anyway. Yeah, Topson going after Fly. Sent the illusions in to give some extra information. He's got the defensive spear on the other side of the tree lines with Slide of Fist. He'll have the damage while SumaiL's being locked in by Jurek. Oh. Supports arrive from Seb. They're moving over SumaiL. The Sprout controls him, but that's why Quillian Blade's there to cut him back out. And EG, they're bringing a lot of TP support into this area. Batrider as well as the Tusker. Crit and S4 have arrived. Takes a while before Inertia kicks, like, actually shifts. S4 looking for a lasso. Cogs, really nice burn. That's the one thing S4 can fly over, but he still gets pushed back. Get the lasso out. They really want to commit with that big ability. While into mid, the fight's going towards the Oracle as Topson once again battling through, and Seb will arrive just up on the higher ground to ensure the kill. You don't care if he's stealing everything, because he'll give it back with the lane pressure.
Blocking his camps, trying to get aggressive, and now actually applying pressure.
To mid.
He might end up stunning himself?
Concoction. Oh, he is able to... Actually, no, he did. He actually ended up stunning himself, but the kill does come onto Seb. He was standing right on top of him. GRX in a little bit of trouble. The snowball comes forward, but Anna, he's looking and ready to fight. He's already taken the bottom tier 1 tower. I don't know if GRX will survive long enough, and yeah, Anna realizes he's underneath Observer Wards, and he'll back up. Juggernaut's having a crack towards the mid lane. As underneath the tower, Topson still wants to get
poor
the
Fly.
It's just focus on the Oracle. He's actually going to have to false promise himself. There's enough Slide of Fist damage while the snowball moves over towards Sven. There's Jirax on the way, and maybe they don't actually see him. Seb, he's protected inside the Sprout. They had no way to cut it free. So Jirax lets the Purge out. Meanwhile, Fly has finally fallen down, but Topson and Anna combining together. They're bringing the might of OG underneath the dead tier 1 tower in mid lane. Anna's already got himself the double kill, but can he get out of this one? He's hidden inside of the shadows, and the cogs from Sockshka splits up the fight again. You get the lasso up, but Topson, he'll come back in once more with the Searing Chains, looking for the revenge on S4. One more slight will do it. No, it won't. S4's bottled up through all of this, and now Topson is stranded, getting spun down, but it's SumaiL who gets the kill, and they're battling into the beefy Alchemist. And OG, they brought everyone they could. The Concoction will fly forward, so they're not done just yet. With the Flame Break, they'll push poor little Jirax down to give SumaiL a triple kill on this Alchemist.
Just pushing him off tower though, so now EG's gonna be confident to die.
There's your concoction. Point forward will be revealed underneath the town. No way Clockwork can respond to that.
It's possible.
You do not want to be there. Or maybe he does. He's gonna get the lasso off, canceling the TP of Sockshka. And this will now mean drag him underneath the shrine. Cox is a good pushback, but the snowball from Crit will get forward. He's looking for a hookshot away to his teammates out to safety. And he could not hit the line to Anna. Well blocked up by EG, and they'll hold him in the igloo.
On Topson, he's looking to get aggressive.
Yeah, I think if she wants to go back in, because they've got extra help, Sockshka. Also, Mal just blinks into the middle of the cog, so that'll be one dead Clockwork. Jirax wants to help out, lets out the Purge.
But
they're looking for
OG are doing such a great job of slowing down this game's pace. Topson, specifically, has been such an annoying gnat.
Well, now they jump the blink. It was revealed for the first time here, and Topson will go down. 48 seconds on the sideline. They can take the tier 1 tower and mid. My life's not worth that much. I can yawn.
But how many times have we seen OG fight around the pit to great success? This is a big part of them winning that TI last year.
They're wrapping from multiple sides. Roshan's almost dead. The Clockwork. Rocket gets information. Anna's now moving in. GRX is in here. Gets the first disruption off. They're inside the pit. And Roshan killed by the Dire. Who's got the Aegis? SumaiL got the Aegis, the Immortal. But Anna, he's looking to get himself back out of here. Now Topson, he's respawned back up. GRX can be stunned, but up and towards the air. Up goes SumaiL, and the Illusion's looking to body block him up, but SumaiL, he's kind of caught on the wrong side of the river, looking to battle against Jirax, but now Topson will arrive. They'll cut off the back line, while Seb's having his own battle with S4, as well as Fly and Arteezy. You can head back towards the mid, where SumaiL is still kind of alone.
He's gotta get out.
Who cares about Seb? You gotta care about SumaiL. He's worth so much money. Concoction flies forward. Jirax missed the touch, sent up into towards the air once again, and SumaiL's losing all of this essence, all of this life. He'll burn the Aegis of the Immortal. The rest of EG is trying to come back, but remember, they TP to bottom lane. Buyback from Seb. They need to keep the control over on SumaiL, and they've got it. The damage output.
God.
He is down 600 100 gold goes to Topson for ending the 5x kill streak of SumaiL. It's a bit of a contradiction. Anna, ooh, he's got to be careful. Whoa. He's pouncing himself forward. He wants to try and find a kill. Fly be the first target. The snowball forward and lasso. JerAx need to help save him.
Disrupt.
They haven't actually got him. Where's the disruption? Where's the save? It actually comes out in time. But can the Slack get himself away from this? They're all over him and the Omni Slash too. Oh. Anna will go down for 52 seconds and this has to be a full retreat. Seb's on the wrong side of the river. Here's your SumaiL blink forward. The stun onto JerAx. They'll bring down this SD. It's taking some time, but they've got him. Hookshot from Seb, trying to create some space.
Oh,
I mean,
no.
From Sockshka. Then Seb TPing out, but the Concoction Suns are all there. A double kill for SumaiL, and such a long death timer for Seb.
Use these blinks to find kills.
Sockshka in trouble. Here comes your snowball forward. He's going to let the cogs up, and oh, they're not close enough. You do hold him in position with the shards. Another quick slide of fist. SumaiL looking for his concoction stun, which will follow Topson up into the trees.
Himself.
And now with a slide of fist, he slides more damage. Anna has arrived. They've got the control on S4. He'll go down the tree line. SumaiL wants to find a concoction target. It's only going to be JerAx. He's really hating on this SD. And Anna and Topson just playing from both sides. Now Seb will finally come and join the fight.
Oh,
triggers up Mjolnir. He's got a BKB available. The creep is going to soak up most of the Omni Slash, but there's enough of it left. Seb trying to back up a disruption out once again. And you've got the control. Topson will fall. He has no buyback available. Seb's TP, it will complete.
Man, such a sick game from S4 so far. He had such a terrible laning phase. Teams have a timing. It's all going to come down to initiation. S4 has to get a lasso.
He's looking at Topson. There's Prophet just around the corner. There's your blink lasso target. And OG, are they just going to leave him for dead? They're looking at him. It's like, yeah, we don't want anything to do with this. Just run.
Not to mention you have the clock, you can separate the team.
Hang on. Sorry, but that's not real. And the Omni Slash
beacon. Oh, now
they'll jump forward. A perfect double searing chains. Can they keep the control going? Arteezy needs to die here. No hookshot available. They just purge Arteezy. He can't move fast. Now they're battling into the shrine. Crits come in. This is not what EG wanted. They're gonna lose Arteezy's Aegis the Immortal. The snowball forward. Sockshka will end up falling
BKB
down. But
Seb.
The battle, SumaiL, he needs to go big right now. But Topson, he just spirit jumped himself away. And with a BKB from Seb, he can stand his own ground. SumaiL pushing himself in a little bit further forward. JerAx just need to keep the control on him, and they've got him. Anna leeches up the false promise. Will allow SumaiL to fight a little bit longer, but these defensive heal centers from JerAx makes it so difficult for SumaiL just to finish the damn job. Finally, he'll end up killing off the SD. Sasha's coming back to the fight while Topson's been such a nuisance.
Oh, he got the
shot! Concoction! It followed through, but the buybacks will arrive and Topson straight back in. Another double searing chains, continuing the way this whole thing began. And Seb, what have you got? A disruption out. This will isolate SumaiL. They're going to bring him down. Three heroes from EG on the sideline, but they want
Topson.
More. Look how far he can move! The Aghanim Scepter Ember Spirit looking to catch Arteezy underneath the shrine. He's moved up, begins a TP, one tree to give him that cover fire, and he'll get himself away to safety.
Dude, what a play from Arteezy. He's doing so much damage to the base now.
They're gonna force buybacks. They have no other choice right now. They need to get Alchemist to buyback, waste something from him. The Shards don't do enough. Arteezy's there, perched up, and this is very problematic because Seb just hitting through. They take a tier 3 tower. Sockshka looking for the hookshot in the back lines. Still, these two buybacks are available, but Chris dying. Anna can't finish the job just yet.
He's
under the tier 4 towers. They'll claim him. Now the buyback comes in, but it's from the Tusker. It's not from the Alchemist. The melee Rax is going to go down, and OG will retreat. They got what they came for, and can they get out safely? Of course they can. Juggernaut, Arteezy pushing in through the mid.
He's just
beating through.
Anna and level 25. Oh my god.
Yep. Arteezy's beating the tier 3 tower down. They're just sending illusion after illusion forward. So now, Anna, this is your time to try and fight. The tier 3 tower is very, very low. Remember, the Scylla Rags up, and JerAx will just make a couple of copies. He didn't get SumaiL, which is the one he kind of wants.
I think Jug's not more important. He just does so much right-click damage. The Radiance is more of a non-factor, and it's good. OG's just buying time.
S4, he got the jump in. It's over on Sockshka. You got 7 seconds before Seb's
no
back up again. Sockshka has no buyback available. And Anna, in the back lines, he's already been perched up a little bit, but now he got another disruption. This is the one he wanted. He got SumaiL. Arteezy's in pretty deep. Spider Fist Searing Chains, keeping some problems in the back lines. SumaiL could just instantly retreat back out. And now the Omni Slash, the two of them are sharing it. The False Promise protects Fly, but it's a fenced one.
Oh, SumaiL,
that
he's just dead.
Helps SumaiL. He gets back in again. Arteezy's Omni Slash didn't do enough work. Now JerAx wants to create more copies, trapping them inside the sprout. While Crit can't move away, Anna is holding him in position, and he just needs to finish the job. The Dark Pack lets him break free, so he's got the movement speed, while Topson just killed Arteezy for almost over 1,500 gold for him. And it ain't done yet. Crit will fall. It's not going to catch out Anna, but now you've got two heroes you can't even control. And Anna moves in. The creep wave is pushing in through the mid lane. So the backdoor protection, it won't actually activate. So Anna could just keep going. They know he cannot be initiated on. So he'll take this melee Rax without a fight. They can't use the buyback on the Juggernaut either. It would be such a huge cost. So they just get two lanes of Rax now in favor of OG. And the team who's playing with a standard without their captain, they're in a position right now where they have the net worth advantage against Alchemist for the first time in 40 minutes. minutes.
And this is a Slark with 35 stacks of agility currently maintained, Toby. Like, this is not going to get any easier for EG. They have no glyph.
Oh, look at the spirit jump. Topson wants to initiate. SumaiL's already got the concoction up. Blinks forward, looks for Seb, but Seb just BKBs, transfers with a hex, and they hold him inside the sprout.
One,
but
that's four.
The damage output is huge. Anna knows he just has to finish him, and they've got him. Topson reaches him with a slide of fist. Down for 70 seconds. Buyback is available for the Batrider.
OG managed to take this with no tail, watching from his phone in the hospital. I don't think North American Dota player.
I'm cheering for you boys. Spirit jump forward, slide of fist.
Hook shot.
Sockshka, the stand-in, pushing him back with the searing chains. Arteezy's forced to spin himself away, but Cr1t, he got trapped. He had just enough time to back up SumaiL. Looking for his own. The lasso is a good target, and it's a big one. Can they bring down? Yes, they can. But for now, it gives extra information. If someone comes to deward that, like,
Seb's going into the base.
S4, you can go for that. But Seb, the creep wave hasn't pushed in through the bottom just
yet.
That's why the rats nature out with the disruption. They're looking. S4, initiating the back lines. No, they don't. They're just trying to bait them into some level of fight. And up and towards the air, the hook shot is perfect from Sockshka with the cock pushback. Flying SumaiL, they're trapped here at Roshan. Forced to fight. Seb, he's taking the main tracks. He wants to get the Megas, but the lasso will end up canceling it. Cr1t hiding on almost no life in the tree lines. They want to bring more heroes back to finish this job, and they're going to have it. But Seb, how much damage have you got? He's going to try and find the kill, but no, the hex, the stun. SumaiL holds him there. Seb maybe thinks he can get a kill. Can't do it. So close to Megas. Roshan remains alive. Yep. The middle lane's coming in, and with that middle lane arriving, all Seb has to do is TP to the top and take the racks, but you keep your eyes focused on Roshan. They get the searing chains off. This is problematic. Cr1t will go down.
Come
he can
fight
back, and there's Seb's TP. He's doing it right now. He's taking the melee racks. The middle
fight
lane
the
didn't arrive, but they're back in the pit with the Omni Slash. A spirit jump away from Topson. He'll get out, and is still hard and fighting. There's no way to really escape. The Juggernaut's falling to the False Promise, and that's what could be saving him. Fly, giving him the light, but now Anna will move for the support. Any kind of hero they can grab, Topson, he doesn't find the core. They'll move over for the support instead. If they can claim Roshan, they'll be happy with this. The Megas were not claimed, however. SumaiL rebought his BKB. Right, okay, whatever. Spirit jump out. Now they jump in closer. SumaiL able to get the concoction off. That's problematic for Slark. They can't break it free. The Aegis Immortal's going to burn, but the Mega Creeps are already up and running.
No
Sockshka hook shots forward, tries to create the space with a cog pushback. 1.5 until the concoction stun flies forward. Is able to connect, but he's inside the invis and disruption. It'll all buy that little bit more time for Ant just to pop himself outside the sprout. Begin his TP under the shadow, and they cannot find him. Sentries do not see through smoke. Oh boy.
It's all about the vision.
Silver Edge being done. Sockshka, he doesn't want him. He wants SD. Anna pouncing himself forward. A hook shot. Wow, really? That didn't hit anything? All right, sure. Arteezy jumps right on top of Sockshka. Doesn't find the kill just yet, but they got it on SD. Cr1t will finish the kill onto the clockwork, but now it's up at the cause of OG. Jumping forward, Anna needs the kill on SumaiL, and he's going to claim him as well. A minute and a half, or 2 minutes down, but that's why buyback is available. Topson, he's looking for something on the top lane, but nothing is there for him to find. Seb,
Anna's so low.
His ground. The damage output. There's no beyond your proxy. It doesn't matter. Arteezy will fall. He has no buyback. He bought out and then they isolate Cr1t. The shards are there, but Topson will return for the fight. The Ghost Scepter delay is the inevitable. The death of Cr1t and maybe the elimination of evil geniuses. OG will push down the mid. They'll attack the tier 4000 with a spirit jump as well as the chains. They have enough to get the kill and good game ball played. OG have done it. They have eliminated EG in the first round of the lower bracket. This best of one ensures EG are nowhere near three, and OG, they keep their own fate in their hands. It would have been a bad situation if they got kicked out of TI9 through DPCs. But Sockshka, yeah, be happy, man. You helped your team get there. But my God, what a great draft. What a great concept from OG.
Seriously, I can't believe they just did that. With Sockshka standing in a day of practice to work with, they play against an EG ALK draft. First two ALK, by the way. Tons of confidence coming in from the boys in blue. And they just stall and poke and annoy and harass until eventually they just drag out this win. Like, I question whether EG played too passively, though.